valley in the early morning rain. Wild geese over the water, heading north and home again, bringing a warm wind from the south, bringing the first taste of the spring. His mother took him to her breast, softly she did sing. Oh, Montana, give this child a home. Give him a love of a good family and a woman of his own. Give him a fire in his heart. Give him a light in his eyes. Give him the wild wind for a brother and the wild Montana skies. His mother died that summer and he never learned to cry. He never knew his father and he never did ask why. And he never knew the answers that would make an easy way. But he learned to know the wilderness and to be a man that way.
He gave her silver rings and lacy things. She promised to wed before the snows came that year.
Coffee.
Fire in his heart, give him a light in his eyes, give him the wild wind for a brother in the wild Montana skies. On the eve of his 21st birthday, he said,
John, Big John.
After 5 hours of driving, we finally arrived at where we're going to be camping. So I'll turn
the pages and make a brand new start. Now I never told the story the time he was gone. Some say he was a lawyer, some say he was a
job. Hi, this is Grandpa.
Here we are. Woo! Campsite.
And Rob, who you've seen in the car. And Dad, who you've probably seen.
Hi. Are you?
Give him the love of a good family and a woman of his own. Give him a fire in his heart. Give him a light in his eyes. Give him the wild wind for a brother and the wild Montana sky. Now some say he was crazy. Some are glad he's gone. Some of us will miss him. We'll try to carry on. Giving a voice to the forest. Giving a voice to the dawn. Giving a voice to the wilderness in the land that he lived on. Oh, Montana, give this child a home. Give him a love of a good family and a woman of his own. Give him a fire in his heart. Give him a light in his eyes.
Help me make it through some lonely nights. Whoa, what a friend to have on a cold and lonely night. His old guitar
in his eyes, giving the wild wind for a brother.
Okay, it is 6:30 in the morning, right, Dad?
Right.
It's kind of dark. The sun has not come up yet. Our goal is to get to our spot before the sun comes up. And I'm freezing, not gonna lie. I'm wearing long underwear, a sweatshirt, a down coat, and this giant coat here.
Carhartt jacket.
Hat, wool pants, and I'm still freezing. So hopefully it warms up when the sun comes up.
His eyes are cold and restless, and his wounds have almost healed. And she give half of Texas just to change the way he feels.
Trying to find a spot where we can pull over and scan the countryside to find our next stop. I thought that we could play a little game where we quiz Dad to see how much he truly knows about hunting. And maybe you guys can learn something too. So, Dad, why do we wear hunter's orange?
Because deer and antelope are colorblind, but men are not, so
they don't see the orange, but the hunters see you. They don't get shot.
She knows his love's in Tulsa, and she knows he's gonna go. Well, it ain't no woman, flesh and blood, it's that damn old rodeo. It's bulls and blood, it's the dust and mud, it's the roar of a Sunday crowd. It's the white in his knuckles, the gold in the buckle, he'll win the next go round. It's boots and chaps, it's cowboy hats, it's spurs and let it go.
So,
it's the roasts and the reins and the joy.
Watching those antelope run away from us.
They're still running.
Yeah, they're still running. Anyways, so while we were up here, we found another two groups. It's amazing how many antelope are out here. But the issue is, the wind is not in our favor, so it's blowing from behind us, meaning it's sending our smell straight to the animals, and they can smell us, and that spooks them, and they're going to take off running. So in order for us to get a good stalk, we're going to have to come from a different side so that the wind is coming at us.
It'll drive a cowboy crazy, it'll drive a man insane. He'll sell off everything he owns just to pay to play the game. And a broken home and some broken bones is all he'll have to show for all the years that he's been chasing this dream they call.
Okay, so this here is a pronghorn antelope shot in Broadus, Montana. It was about a 200-yard shot. We shot him with a 270 Browning A-bolt action. One shot, one kill, ran just a little bit and ended up right here. Okay, next question. Just so you know why we're bouncing, because this road is incredibly uneven. Next question. What is the difference between a shotgun and a rifle?
Rifle has rifle barrel and shoots one bullet long distances. A shotgun sprays out lots of pellets to hit birds. And mostly used for birds. Only used for birds.
I've been looking for a sound that makes my heart sing. Been looking for a melody that makes the church bells ring. Not looking for the fame or the fortune it might bring. In love.
We're still antelope hunting, but as we were walking through the gully, a nice size buck for me. Okay, let's
I think it's a whitetail.
Ooh, whitetail. I haven't gotten the opportunity to shoot many big buck deers. So this buck deer is pretty big for me, and I'm freaking out right now. So basically, he jumped up. We laid down on the ground in prone position. Put the guns up, and he was standing 100 yards. He was trotting up, and then he made the mistake by stopping and turning broadside. And one shot, one kill. That's what we aim for, and that's what happened. So now we're just gonna wait here for a little bit, make sure that he does die, because a lot of times, I just want to tell them why we wait. So a lot of times, you shoot the animal, and if you go after it right away, it still has adrenaline pumping in it and it's not quite dead yet. It'll jump up and it'll run. So we're just gonna sit here, make sure he dies, lays there and dies so that he doesn't take off running and we lose our animal. So we think he's down. He hasn't moved for a little bit now. So I'll show you when we get there.
Jesus preached the golden rule.
So it's currently raining. It's been raining all morning. But Rob, early on, saw a huge buck, and he decided to go out in the rain and stalk it. It's been about an hour and a half, and we finally got a call from him. He got it. It's down. So now we're driving.
I got the medication. Love is the remedy. Pray to be stronger and wiser.
A slug, and when is it used?
A slug is a one projectile that comes used with a shotgun. You use it, it's required to use in eastern states like suburbs of New York City, where you don't want the bullet to go very far, where a rifle bullet, high-powered rifle bullet, which we're using today, can go over a mile, where a slug only goes a couple hundred yards.
You get what you give. Let this heart be my guide in love, in music, in life.
Last question. What is our tradition after duck hunting in Montana?
After duck hunting?
Yep.
Our tradition in duck hunting?
Yeah.
Go eat a big breakfast?
At a diner.
There you go.
There we go. 100%.
Thank you.
So today is day two of our annual antelope hunt. Yesterday you saw us give Dad a quiz, so today we're going to give Rob a quiz. He's with us in the back here. Say hi, Rob.
Hi.
Okay, Rob, what is the difference between a buck and doe?
Bucks have antlers, and you know what? And does don't have antlers, and yeah.
So in the hunting world, a buck means... what?
It has a penis.